Hello, hello. I am back with a graphic design video. If you've watched my like most recent studio vlogs, you'll see that I want to do more videos like this, where I sit down in a proper little setup and I do graphic design work on my iPad or my laptop, or I share my thoughts, feelings and knowledge. That knowledge that I do have anyway. So yeah, I hope you like this setup. It's taken me a while to get to this. It's very strange filming in a new location. Obviously I've moved house since the last time I filmed a video like this, so I hope you like it. Let me know if there's anything you want me to change. Anyway, I'm going to stop rambling. We are going to make a seamless pattern design in Adobe Illustrator. I believe I've done something like this before. I'm not sure whether it was Procreate or Illustrator. Either way, I'll leave any similar videos linked in the description. And yeah, we're going to just jump straight into it. So let's head over to the laptop. So I have Adobe Illustrator open and you can see I have two different artboards. So on the left I have some inspiration images along with a colour palette across the bottom, and then on the right that's where we're going to create some ideas, and then I'll probably create a few artboards as we move forwards. But as you can see, I'm going for this sort of, I believe it's called Memphis style, but something a little bit more simple. A lot of Memphis patterns can be quite busy, more like this one in the bottom left. Whereas I quite like the idea of this one up here, something simple. There's like, what, five different shapes in there and they've just been rotated and it repeats. So that's the plan. First up, I need to make all the different shapes. I'm actually going to pretty much mirror the shapes in this, maybe add in a few variations, and we'll just see how it goes. We're just doing a design with me. So I thought I'd ease myself in on these new videos. Okay, so first up, let's make some shapes. So we'll go square, circle, that's not a circle, circle, what else have we got? A triangle, top tip, if you want to make a triangle, so this is a polygon tool, if you press the down arrow on your keyboard, you'll get to a triangle. If you press up, it'll add more sides. I feel like that's a very useful tip that I wish I'd known sooner. Okay, so we've got some shapes. I'm thinking I might add some more as we go forwards, but I'm going to try and keep it simple. That's the aim of this. I tend to overcomplicate things and I strive for perfection, which I can never reach. What even is perfect? What defines that? So one of my mantras for this year is to like curb my perfectionism, because I'm a bit OCD about that. Firstly, I want them to have no fill. I think I want to up the width of their lines. And do I want the corners rounded? No, we'll leave it like that. Then what I'm going to do is similar to these two at the top. I'll just zoom in so you can see. They've like got colours in the background of like the exact same shapes. So I'm basically going to duplicate the shapes and make them like full colours behind. Don't know if that makes sense, but we'll see. Don't know if it'll look good, but we'll see. It's all about experimentation here. And I'm sure if you've watched my channel for a while, you will know that. I don't claim to be an expert. I just like sharing what I do. And hopefully along the way, you can learn something too.
If you are enjoying this video, don't forget to click the subscribe button and join my little creative family.
So we're going to pick up these colours. I found this colour palette on Adobe Colour. It's free to use as well, and because I have an Adobe subscription, I can automatically like sync it to my software, so I basically just press download and it's already in my Illustrator like software, which is obviously great. How many shapes? Six shapes and only five colours, because obviously we're not going to include the black. Maybe let's add a green. Should we see if we can pick up this green from in here? That's quite cool. I'm thinking maybe switch these two round, so maybe do that one. No, actually, I like the yellow. This is my perfectionism. This is me just tweaking things for the sake of it. Maybe this blue. That could work. And then obviously we want all these in the background. We'll send them to the back. I guess that's it for the elements. I actually might add some dots as we go further, like forward, because I like these here on this one down here. Just dots, you know, with no colours in the background. I think that looks quite cool. So we'll see. We'll see how busy it looks. So now I've got my shapes. I'm going to just move them across here. So they're on the side. So one thing when I'm making a seamless pattern, I need to make note of how big the artboard is. So this artboard is 15 centimeters by 15 centimeters. So just remember that number, make sure it's like a nice solid number, nothing too complicated. If you want a more in-depth tutorial of this, let me know and I will do it. For the purpose of this video, I'm just gonna design and throw in a few tips as we go. So let me know if you'd like a tutorial version of it. Right, I'm gonna group these together. So what I'm going to do now they're grouped, I'm just going to move them onto the artboard. So I'm going to do it like this, keep them quite nicely spread, and I am going to duplicate a couple of them. So I don't just want one cross and I don't just want one triangle, you know. And maybe I could change the colours between them, that'd be quite fun. Let me show you how this would look as a pattern. So what I'm going to do is take the M tool, which is the rectangle tool, and I'm going to create a square that's 15 by 15. Remember that number, the size of the artboard? And I'm going to align that perfectly above the artboard, get rid of its stroke. And then all I do is highlight all of that with that invisible shape on top, drag it into the swatch panel, and then in the swatch panel is now a pattern. So if I zoom out and if we press that, you'll see that the pattern is now repeating. So obviously in this we only have six, but it's mirroring itself in like a tiled form. You can change how it mirrors and stuff, but for now we're just going to leave it quite simple. So what I want to do is, just because that one is very odd, I've not placed them or anything, I'm going to just move things around. So let's try that. So this I still have this like invisible square on top, the 15 by 15 one. I'm going to drag this over into there again and just zoom out and see what that looks like. So there we go. That's what that looks like right now. Obviously it doesn't have a white background. We can add that in. So I actually like that. That's quite cool. My instinct is to move this triangle to the right a little bit because there is quite a gap here. Maybe nudge these around. There's two ways of me doing this. I could either nudge it in here, literally just move them around, sort of guesstimate where they need to go, highlight them all, drag it out, do that. But there is actually a way of doing it within this artboard itself. So if you double click this, now we have the pattern itself. So these are a load of pattern options. Again, I'll do a tutorial on this if you want me to. We'll go in more detail. But I am going to, I'm going to show tile edge. So this square here in the middle with the blue rectangle around it, that is what it's working from. That's the part that it's moving. And you'll see if I move one element in it, it's moving all of them. So this yellow cross, if I move it, it's moving all the similar yellow crosses. This yellow cross is a different one. So, and you can see, we can sort of align it within here. This is something I didn't know existed when I very first made patterns. Doing it like this makes it a lot easier. Maybe not so in a more complex pattern. Like I create patterns for my friend's dog harness business and they aren't quite as easily editable in this format. But for something quite simple like this, I think it works quite well. And I think I want to make this with a white background for now. Obviously we can change it. Once I've made those tweaks, by the way, you press done and it'll like overlay it. If you press save or copy, it'll create a new version of it. Just realized my camera wasn't recording, so let's pretend that didn't happen. Can you tell I've not been back for a while? You know, you guys know me by now. So press done. I want to create the white background. So to do that, I'm gonna create a square that's 15 by 15 again. I want to make sure it's white fill, which it is. And I'm gonna put it directly underneath this. So at the minute, there we go, align underneath, cool. So then this time, it has the white background on it, it has the elements on it, and it still has that invisible square at the very top. So I'm gonna highlight it, drag it over, and then this time, this, when I click this new swatch here on the right, it'll have a background on it. And you know what? I actually really like that. I'm very happy with myself. And I think I'm going to nudge this circle up a little bit. I'm going to do it this way. You'll see that it's got the white background like I wanted. Probably should have done that at the beginning, but you know. There we go. Press done. And I mean, technically we have a seamless pattern. Have I already completed the video? Possibly so. But I'm going to show you another way that I can do it as well. So the other way of doing this is a little more complex, and in this case it's actually not really necessary because things aren't overlapping, but for things such as like the dog harness designs that I do for my friend, they're very complex and they have like big branches and they all like interlace, so that's when you have to do what I'm about to do. When you want it to overlay, I'm just going to move this up so I've got some more room. I would put this to the edge here. Let's put this to the edge. So then it sort of starts fitting together like a bit of a jigsaw piece. So, I mean, the placements of these might be a bit off, but we can figure it out. So these left-hand bits here, these ones that I'm highlighting, they are like so far over the edge. I need that to be mirrored exactly on the other side. To do that, I am going to click them both, hold the shift key, press copy, and then I'm going to paste it in front, which for me is Command F. It might be different depending what computer you have. Again, I'll do a tutorial if you want me to. And then we press transform, and either on the X or the Y, I get it wrong every time, I go to the very edge of that and type in plus 15. I actually pressed the right one. So now it's nudged them up, the copies of them up, exactly 15 centimeters, which I now know is the size of my artboard, so that's overlaid enough. Same applies for like the top and the bottom. So if I move these up a little bit, let's say these two are sort of overlaid. Again, highlight them both, copy, paste in front, transform, and this will be on the Y. This could be minus, I think it is, minus 15. Nope. See, this is all about experimentation. I'm telling you, not an expert. Plus 15. And it jumps 15 down. When I did minus, it basically jumped up, and you can't see it because I'm zoomed in. So there is that. Now, one of the main things is now if I make any changes, I can't just nudge this to the right because this one's not fastened to it. It's not going to just automatically move. So what I need to do is either click them both or group them or whatever so they move in unison. So now I can move them to the right, to the left, up or down. And because they are exactly 15 centimeters apart, they'll move around together. So yeah, that's just another way of doing it. Let me make this into a pattern so you can sort of see how it looks. This is not very well spaced out at all, but you'll get the idea. If I highlight, it's still got the invisible square on it. Drag into here and I'll make a new pattern over here. If I click that new swatch, I did it wrong. Oh, hang on. Okay, let's carry on. We can do this. Why is it doing that? I bet that invisible square isn't there. So let's take this as a learning lesson. So let's have a look what's behind here. We have the filled in square right behind. I'm going to copy, paste in front and bring that right in front. I'm just talking myself through it at this point, aren't I? Then get rid of the fill so it's invisible. Now we highlight, drag, zoom out, cross your fingers. Okay, something's not going right here. Let's try a different method. So what I'm going to do, I've got my invisible square, as you can see, directly above, and I'm actually going to make a clipping mask. So I'm going to cookie cutter it out effectively. So Command 7, and it means that it's got rid of everything that's like overlaying. It might work. It might not. We will find out. Let's do this. Can you tell it's been a while since I've done this? So I've just made a new swatch, dragged it in, cross your fingers. Okay, this is not what the idea is. Size tile. I've just fixed it. So all I needed to do was size tile to art. Rookie error. So it was width needs to be at 15 and height needs to be at 15. So all I needed to do to fix the other one, like this one that I didn't make a compound path for, or a clipping mask, sorry. All I needed to do was size tile to art by 15. There we go. And actually, I've messed up, look. You can see here, this is not in alignment at all. So obviously when I was showing you what not to do, I did it. So let's just go back over here and quickly sort that out. So I'm just going to release that clipping mask because we didn't even need that. I did think I was doing something wrong. And what I'm going to do is delete this copied one and just copy this back over. So copy, paste in front, and then plus 15. Make sure I've still got my transparent rectangle. I do. And then drag this over into here. And in theory, I figured it out. Let's see. Let's click this. It needs adjusting. That's fine. We know how to do it now. Size tile to art. Or just type in here 15. By 15. Hooray! I've done it. So this is my repeatable pattern, and I've actually ended up showing you two ways of doing it. I really like this. I could also add like the dots in the background or extra dots, but I mean, for the purpose of this video, I think this was a really good exercise. Like this one, you see it's got dots. We could do that. We could add more little fiddly twiddly elements into it. But all in all, especially after I got a little bit confused, I think I'm really happy with those. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was a nice, easy way back into me doing graphic design videos. The plan moving forward is for me to do 2 videos a week. So on Tuesdays, there will be studio vlogs or just vlogs in general, life vlogs, whatever I feel like vlogging. And on Thursdays, like today, I will be doing graphic design content, whether that's a design with me like this, tutorial, maybe a challenge, logo redesign, anything like that. So yes, I'm very excited for my channel moving forward. I hope you're looking forward to joining me, and don't forget to click that subscribe button. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.